לבן. זה עושה שאני רואה לבנה.
זה כן, היא פחות לבנה.
Hey guys, so I'm just here to explain some things. So in this video, I just wanted to say that number one, like half of the time my mom's face is like completely out of focus whenever I'm doing her makeup, and I do apologize for that. I was just going back and forth a lot to like the makeup products and her, then the different sides, and it was really hard to keep it in focus the whole time, so I'm sorry about that. Second of all, we were also in a very echoey room, so I know that the audio isn't that good because it's very echoey, so again, I'm sorry. And third of all, if this is like your first time seeing me or you don't know me, we speak Hebrew at home, so there's not like a lot of those clips, but it's actually funny because it's kind of awkward for us to just be speaking in English when no one else is in the room, but we did it for the camera. So there are times where I'm talking to her in Hebrew, so I'll just put captions and stuff on those. So yeah, I was just kind of explaining some things for any like people who might be confused.
Okay, hey guys, so today I'm here with my mother. And so today is gonna be an interesting video because I'm going to kind of be giving her a makeover. Not really a makeover. I'm not like choosing her outfit or doing her hair or anything because her hair looks just fine. My mom never wears makeup. In fact, I don't think she's ever worn a full face of makeup in her life.
Actually, I did, but that was on stage when I was pretending to be Elvira.
So my mom does not wear makeup. So she literally really doesn't own much makeup, so we actually had to go out and buy her a foundation and a concealer because as you can see, we are clearly not the same shades. In fact, I look like a ghost right now because I'm standing next to you right now. So even though she doesn't look super dark in this video, she naturally is olive skinned, so she's a lot darker than me, hair wise, skin wise, everything wise. I've done my mom's makeup in the past. The first time I did my mom's makeup, I think
I went to a PTO meeting afterwards and they all thought I looked very odd.
What are you talking about? No, I think so I've only done my mom's makeup two other times before, but I didn't really like do her makeup because first of all, one problem was the first time I tried to do it, I was like 12 years old and I was still experimenting with makeup. I could barely do my own, let alone other people's. The second time was because I, like I said, we're not the same shade and I used a foundation that was mine on her. And so it like ruined the whole look. If you use like a shade that's lighter on someone for their foundation, that just pretty much ruins the whole look. So today I want to do a really good job on her. The problem is I really don't have a lot of experience in doing other people's makeup. I only do my own. I don't really get to experiment with other people. So I'm excited to see how my mother is going to turn out today. And we brought makeup wipes because she doesn't trust my skills, but I want to show her that I can do her makeup well.
Right.
She also hates makeup, so I had to convince her to do this video with me. This is the before, and stay tuned if you want to see how she looks after. Okay guys, this is my mom's bare face. And so first, I'm gonna be using a moisturizer to moisturize her face. Also, by the way, mom, I'm going to be explaining all the products to you and what they do as I go through this, just so that this is kind of like educational as well. Okay, I forgot to bring hair clips. I was gonna bring hair clips to clip your hair back. Okay, I think you need to cut the seam. This shall come on. Okay, mom, now I'm gonna use this primer on you. So if you guys can see, it's the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer.
What does the face need?
It says it smooths and blurs.
It blurs
so
your face?
So it's this lightweight primer, smooths, perfects, and preps skin for makeup application. So it says it blurs flaws and creates a soft focus finish, and it's water-based and oil-free, so it won't make you oily. I'll put this on my face like dish.
How does it feel, mom?
It's oil-free, Mom. Oh, is there anything you want the viewers, my viewers, to know about you?
Well, if they want to look me up on Amazon, they can look up my author page.
She writes books, so. She also has her own channel, which I will be linking in the description. All right, so now I'm going to be using the foundation that we actually just got her, and we ended up just getting a cheaper drugstore one, which is the Fit Me foundation. I hope that this is her shade. Does it have a name? It's called Warm Nude, and if it's not her shade, it looks like it could be a little bit dark for you, Mom. So what I'm gonna be doing, Mom, is I'm putting this on the back of my hand, like so. I used to use this when I was younger, but like for some reason, all of their shades were way too dark for me. All right, let's just try it. If it's too dark, I will lighten it for you, don't worry. Oh, okay, you know what? This actually looks like it probably is your shade. I'm gonna look back on the camera and realize it's not, but I think it is your shade. What do you think so far?
It smells nice.
You actually like the smell of it? A lot of people don't like this one foundation.
It smells nice.
Just gotta do your forehead now.
Okay. Some people think you're supposed to pronounce that word forehead.
Who are those people?
Well, I think they're the people who used to write poetry.
Blend it down your neck because you don't want your neck to be a different color.
So we're gonna go see Mulan, right?
Yeah, but if it's probably not gonna come out in December, Mom.
No,
when is it gonna come out?
March.
Everyone's excited for Mulan live action, right?
It just reminded me of that scene with the makeup.
So yeah, we're obsessed with Disney, like most people, but I feel like the live actions are hit and miss.
Yes.
Oh, this used to be my favorite concealer. It's the Instant Age Rewind Eraser, and I used to use this all the time as my drugstore concealer, but we got it in her color, of course. As you can see, it's still in the packaging.
So when you were in middle school, you were trying to rewind your age?
I will be putting this under your eyes, just like wherever I would normally put my concealer. All right, so basically you just twist it and concealer comes into it because it's a little sponge. Isn't that cool, Mom?
Yes, it's wonderful. I wish I had one of those to paint with.
Just keep your eye relaxed. You know what, guys? I'm actually gonna use a little bit of my concealer along with it, because I want to brighten her face since I'm gonna contour, so give me 1 second. I'm just gonna use this. It hasn't been on my eyes yet. Okay, I'm gonna go wet this sponge, which I've never used before, really quick, and then I'm going to blend it. Okay, by the way, Mom, this is a beauty blender, and usually we wet it, and then we use
it. Looks like a sponge.
Yeah, that's what it is.
So, do you think that's artists get the skin tones on there?
It's like similar, but it's very different. Let me do my work. Okay, so already, just the face makeup is making a huge difference because I never see my mom with makeup, like I said. Just make sure that I can blend it. And now I'm gonna be going in with bronzer. So this is just the bronzer I usually use, the Physicians Butter Bronzer, and I'm just gonna be taking a big fluffy brush and contouring my mom's face. So I just use this to bring back definition, bring back depth into your face and warmth and stuff like that.
Are you gonna give me cheekbones?
Kind of. It's a good way to define your cheekbones, and also I use it a lot on my forehead to make my forehead look smaller. I think this is as good as it's gonna get because this is like almost the same color as your skin color. Now we're actually done with your face, so now we're gonna go ahead and do your brows. Are you ready for this?
I'm not sure.
You know what? We should have gotten an eyebrow pencil while we were getting your foundation and your concealer. I use the color taupe, so this might not be the right color for my mom. I think it's actually way too light for my mom. But I'm gonna go ahead and work with it because I don't have anything else. First, I'm going to take the brush and just brush them out.
I use my eyebrows to talk.
So I'm just trying to make the natural shape really not mess with them too much, just because I feel like eyebrows are a very personal thing. I feel like everyone does their eyebrows differently. Okay, look at the camera.
Oh, one looks way darker than the other. We gotta fix that. But it's just on camera.
It's not like in real life. It's just on camera that it looks like that. So now I have to fix it for the camera. So now I'm gonna use the concealer that I normally use to carve out your brows.
Why do you have to carve them out?
To carve them out because it's a way to clean them up and make them look more flawless. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It's a way to like shape them the way you want to shape them. The Tarte Shape Tape Concealer.
What's my face shape?
I don't know. Different than mine. You have like a an oval face. Mine's more like heart shaped. I was gonna say that we're different skin shades.
This is way too light for you.
But don't worry, I'll blend it out. Everything okay? Not painful?
But in other respects, it kind of reminds me of a visit to the dentist.
How?
Well, they keep telling you where to sit and what to do. Open your mouth, close your eyes.
Do you actually find this relaxing?
Sort of. Except for all the questions.
It's a video, Mom. You're supposed to talk in it, or else they're gonna get bored. I'm done setting your eyes, and now I'm gonna show you how to bake.
Okay. Is it gonna hurt?
No. It's translucent powder, and I'm just using this, and I'm gonna put it under your eyes, and we're gonna leave it there, and then eventually I'm gonna wipe it off. A little bit on here, see, Mom? Mm-hmm. And then look up, and I'm just putting it under your eyes to bake. I'm gonna remove this whenever it's time. So, I have three palettes. I brought my Brunch Date palette, my Huda Beauty nude palette, and my extra spicy gingerbread palette. Do you wanna use the holiday? Do you want me to try a holiday look on you with the gingerbread one? Or do you want me to just do the Brunch Date one? Do you not want a holiday one at all?
Well, I mean, if I look like a Christmas tree, no.
You're not gonna look like a Christmas tree, Mom. Here, I'm gonna actually do what I usually do on myself on you. So I feel like this is more like a me turning you into me video.
Oh no.
What is that supposed to mean, Mom?
Well, I thought you already knew what I liked.
Close your eyes, I'm gonna put it in your crease. I'm taking the color maple syrup and just blending it into your crease. Does it feel fine?
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, some people use makeup to conceal flaws, but they still try to look natural, right?
I did, but now I just want to do a cute eyeshadow look on you, Mom. It's silly. Focus. I also used the color Mimosa in her crease. So now I think I'm gonna go in with the color Extra Slice and use that in her outer corner. Close your eyeball, this mother.
So is Mimosa kind of pink or kind of gray?
It's like a reddish tone kind of, but it's a brown color.
I remember when we thought Summer was a girl.
Yeah, we misgendered him. I don't want to make it too dramatic. Now I'm going to go ahead and use this super pretty color. This is my favorite shade in this whole palette. I don't even know if this is focused. I can't tell. It says Champagne. It's called Champagne Toast. And it's this color right here. It's this like super shimmery champagne color. It's really pretty, Mom. All right, close your eyes. All right, do you have any embarrassing stories from when I was little?
About makeup?
Or just in general?
I don't know. I don't think anything embarrassing ever happened to you, Sword.
That's not true. You're saying I wasn't an embarrassing child?
No, you weren't.
She's lying to you guys.
She won the spelling bee.
Yeah, I did win the spelling bee. I was a really good speller. That was like my only talent when I was a kid. I did a lot of things. Like, you put me in horseback riding, gymnastics, piano lessons, voice lessons. I mean, like, I think I was okay at a lot of them. Like, there were some where I like barely was proficient at them, but I wasn't like amazing at them.
Well, you learned how to sight read. I'm really proud of you. I used to love to listen to you sing Reflection from Mulan.
All right, now look up. I'm just gonna put these shadows. There we go. And so, that's why I'm saying look up.
So you don't mean like look something up in the dictionary?
No, I'm using the NYX Professional Makeup Ink Liner. This is what I use for my own liners. It's not for me to say you love. Okay guys, so we kind of ended up running out of daytime lighting. I had to do the rest of her eyeliner and her lashes here, and I also did her lips, but I didn't really have a good lip color for her. And I didn't want to do red lipstick because my mom doesn't like the super bright looks. Okay, so this is the final touches. Keep in mind that this is really harsh lighting, so I feel like this doesn't look the best. I feel like this is kind of a fail. It doesn't look as bad in person, so I wasn't able to put any on her bottom lashes, which would have made a huge difference. From far away, it actually looks really good. It's just like up close, it doesn't look as good. So this was kind of a fail, but you do, like, I think you look really good. I just think up close, you can see that there are mistakes in the makeup. So she can't see because she doesn't have glasses on. Mom, just go ahead and put your glasses on and look and tell me what you think.
Okay, well, I look like somebody from the 60s who was on TV, maybe?
From the 60s?
Yeah.
How do you look like someone from the 60s?
It kind of reminds me of Cher on the Sonny and Cher show.
Do you like it?
It's very nice. I don't think I would want to look like this every day, though.
But you think it would be nice for, like, an outing or something if I didn't mess up so badly?
It would be nice for an outing, yes.
I'm not sure how much better this lighting is, but this is my mom's look now. I do think it looks good, like I said, from far away, but then you get up close and you see the mistakes I made, but it's not awful. I really think it depends on the lighting that you're looking at it from. Take your glasses off again so I can show them. Okay, so this is the overall look. And then here's the look.
Well, it's a very glamorous look, very glitzy for me. I'm usually quite reserved and don't go for this type of look, but if I were going to a special gala event, I might.
See, a lot of people are gonna be like, this isn't even that glamorous, but you guys don't understand, my mom never like does glam, never wears like makeup and stuff. This was kind of a fail on my end, honestly, but like, what did you think of this?
It was a fun mother-daughter experience. The problem is when I have my glasses on, then it changes the look, and when I have them off, I can't actually see what I look like, but yeah, it looks good.
I was gonna have her put contacts in for this video, but my mom has very sensitive eyes, and like, she does wear contacts, but I was just afraid that it would be too much if she was wearing contacts and I was putting a bunch of makeup on her eyes that she's not used to wearing, so.
Yeah, I occasionally do wear contact lenses, but I can't stand to wear them more than one day, and so.
So anyways, we hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you want to see more videos with my mom,
you could try my channel.
You can go over to her channel. I will link it below. She has a different audience than me, but she has a really cool channel, so you should go check it out. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe.
super cringy. Also, let me know if me and my mom look like each other. We get that a lot. Like, we get told that we look like each other, but I don't see it.
Neither do I.
So, yeah. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. Bye, guys.
So long.